This is Wayne Byers at the Law Enforcement Center in Jamestown, as we've just finished up another interagency meeting, and the public information officer for the city and county and other entities, Fritz Fremkin, is with us. And Fritz, what were some of the major highlights of today's meeting?
Thanks, Wayne. Really busy day today. I think what I'd like to highlight the most is the bag laying operations with the guard. Yesterday afternoon, they were handed 18 different locations from the engineers that were going to need to be bagged by hand, and they got through five by the time of the 2 o'clock meeting. And now it's about 4:30, and I'll bet that they've got at least another one or two done. So they're about a third of the way through that 18 site mission, and they've got some of the afternoon hours left today and then tomorrow. So they're confident they'll reach that goal and have those 18 sites done by, you know, supper time tomorrow. That's great news, and I give the students and the guard a hand. They learned hurry up and wait, and I was really proud of the students. I never heard a grumble about it. They were out there to do the job, and they had to wait some, and they handled it really, really well. Some other real quickies. Remember to return your pallets, or at least let somebody know that you have them and they maybe can come by and get them. But if you picked them up, we'd really appreciate it if you could take the time to drop them off. Pallets are getting broken as they get picked up by the forklifts. That's a huge, heavy load. When you put 30 of those sandbags on there, it weighs, I think, 1,000 pounds or something. And those pallets are getting smashed up just by use. So we need your empty ones back. If nothing else, put them on your parkway in a stack, and then we can find them. But we really need you to take the time to bring them back if you can. Let me quick cover. You know, it's terrible these rumors get going, but no, nobody's being evacuated at Klaus Park. I was down there when people were deciding, let's get our cars out of our garages and get them so that they're not cut off by the levee once the levee gets put in. But, you know, that's the closest I can come up with to anybody thinking that somebody was being evacuated. And I knew some other kid in an apartment house decided he was going to move out because it was going to be inconvenient with a dike, but there is no evacuation that's been requested that anybody mentioned at the 2 o'clock meeting. One-way streets, the chief has made kind of a oval with 1st and 2nd Street Southwest, and he's made them one-way so that 1st Street Southwest you can only travel west on, and 2nd Street Southwest you can only travel east on, and this runs from 4th Avenue Southwest to 8th Avenue Southwest. So your long sides of your oval, if you will, are 1st Avenue Southwest and 2nd Street Southwest. 1st Street Southwest, 2nd Street Southwest are your long arms, and 8th and 4th Avenue Southwest on your short sides of that oval. He says he's got signs up anyway. He just wanted the public to know that's out there. Otherwise, sandbag operations, the filling went super. We're up at 130,000 in hand, and they were filling 7,000 an hour. And the good news for the public is they are being given away to private residences filled once again.
All right. Thanks very much, Fritz. And this is Wayne Byers at the Law Enforcement Center in Jamestown on this Thursday, April 16th, with our wrap-up meeting from the interagency meeting today.